Hey, what's up guys? I'm back with another video. Hope you guys are doing well. Today I have another rip or opening for you guys. Today I have a 2022 Prizm Baseball Blaster. Find one retail exclusive green, 5 cards per pack, 6 packs per box. And I have a 2022 Elite Extra Edition Blaster box as well. There's Drew Jones and Jackson Holliday on the front of that. Find 2 autographs or memorabilia cards per box on average. I do like the Prizm. We have opened these before. I've done, pretty decent. Says look for the Ultra Lava Flow and Color Blast inserts, and also the White Wave and blue, not blue, but purple Prizms. I do like the White Wave Prizms. Those are really sharp looking. So, this Extra Elite Extra Edition. This is my first time opening this product, so it'll be my first look at this. There's not really much to get into as far as hits and stuff. I'm sure you can get some number cards. There is a base checklist, but I don't know how big it is, but there's not a whole lot in the set, so I'm not too sure about the autos as well. But you can also look for pink parallels too, so for this set, so be nice. Hopefully we hit a nice auto, kick-ass auto. We will start off with the Prizm first, and then we'll get into these autos, the Elite Extra Edition. So we'll start off with the Prizm, and we will do base hits, and then rookies over there. So there is Wander on the front. Hopefully we hit something good out of this. So you get 30 cards per blaster. So let's get into this, guys. Hopefully we have some good luck and we can pull an auto. Hopefully I can pull an auto for you guys. That would be awesome. So wish me luck. Hopefully this blaster will be good to us. I'll show you the packs. I do like the neon green look to them. I've been very upset with Bowman here recently. I bought a ton of blasters and not a lot of hits. It's been very disappointing. Been absolute garbage, and it's not been very good to me, so I'm pretty upset about Bowman. It's pretty much garbage. I haven't really hit nothing good out of Bowman, so I'm pretty bummed about that. Here are the packs. I do like that green. There's Wander on the front. So all right guys, wish me luck. Hopefully we can pull an auto for you guys. That would be awesome. We can hit an auto. So let us do this, guys. Let us hit a sweet pull. Let's do this, guys. Let's pull an auto. Here we go, guys. Let's see what we can pull out of Prizm. Let's get in Wiley Adames to start things off. We have a Justin Verlander. I do want to mention there are tiers, so this is not a tier, it's just a base. That's what the base looks like. But they do have tiers on these as well. So I don't think that... Nope, that... Yeah, that's a tier 2. And Justin Verlander was just a regular. But this is a tier 2 of Wiley Adames. You can see right there. I think tier 4 may be the highest. I could be wrong. It's either 3 or 4. Walker Buehler. And we have a rookie class of Jake Berger. So we do have our first white Prizm. There's Jake Berger on the rookie class. We do have our first white Prizm. Is a rookie card. It is a Jackson Reitz. Very nice. Okay. I do like these white wave Prizms. Those are sharp looking cards. This it will probably be, it's not a tier anything. So I will still get him sleeved up as well, because I do like those Prizms a lot. They're nice looking cards, so it's already cut for me, so we should be good. That is our first white wave Prizm. I'm not going to sleeve these. We'll get into our next pack, pack number 2. Love to pull an auto for you guys. That would be pretty freaking awesome. I would be so happy if we can hit an auto. I was pretty bummed, like I said, out of Bowman. It's kind of making me mad because I spent all that money and didn't hit anything. It's kind of, people kept saying, oh, buy the blaster. Blasters are good, blah, blah, blah. And 2 number cards. That's it. That's all I got. Akil Baddoo. Bryce Harper. I do see a purple coming up. Reese Knur, or Knur. We do have a Fireworks of Randy Rosarena. That's a nice looking card right there. My wife is a big Randy Rosarena fan, so that's cool there. And we do have our first purple. It is a Anthony Rendon. So that's a nice one right there. That's a nice Fireworks right there of Rosarena. Nice insert. I do like those a lot. We do have 4 packs left, guys. So let's see what we can get out of these last 4 packs. See if we can get an auto. I'd love to pull an auto for you guys. Do see another white prism coming up. Kyle Hendricks. Ian Anderson. Tyler Glasnow. We do have a Javier Baez on the Lumber Incorporated. And our white prism is a Francisco Lindor. Those are sharp looking. I do love those white prisms. They are nice looking cards. So, not too shabby, guys. That is a tier 2 on the Francisco Lindor. So, the white prism. Those are nice looking cards. So far, nothing too crazy. Maybe things will heat up. We got 3 packs left, guys. Love, 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 love to pull an auto, guys. Come on, auto. Let this be a good rip. We do have another white wave prism. Chris Bryant. Patrick Mazika. We have an Anthony Rendon. He's been in our box a lot. Silver. He has been... Oh, we do have a backwards card, guys. I think we have an auto. I think we do have an auto. Our white wave prism is a Garrett Cole. That's nice. I think we might have an auto, guys. Super stoked. Garrett Cole in the White Wave Prism. And who is going to be our auto? RAMV. Matt Vierling. Okay. That is our auto right there. Rookie autographs. Nice. Matt Vierling, rookie autograph. And there is a big dent in there, unfortunately. That is kind of It's kind of unfortunate. You can see down there is a big dent right there, but oh well. There's a big dent. It kind of sucks, but oh well. Nothing I can do. Looks like there's a dent in the auto as well. Still, nice to get a autograph, Matt Vierling. So not too shabby, guys. Matt Vierling autograph. Very cool. Let me get that sleeved up. Happy at least to pull an auto for you guys. That's awesome. So we at least hit one auto. Unfortunately, it has a couple ding marks in it. That's kind of disappointing. Yeah, hopefully it's not too bad. It probably won't grade very well, but still, I'm glad we hit something at least. It's not a big auto name, but hey, at least it is an auto. Wasn't expecting that, so still cool to get an auto. Probably won't grade very well. Unfortunately, but still cool. We got an auto, so we set out what we were said we were going to do. So I said I wanted to get an auto, and we hit an auto. So I'm just trying to get him sleeved up real quick, and I will be ready and with you guys. I just hope they don't take too many points off of this, because this is unfortunate and it's nothing I can do as far as the quality. So there we go. Nice Matt Vierling autograph. Very cool. I will gladly take it. An auto hit is an auto hit, so very cool. Let me get that white prism sleeved up. We still have 2 packs left, guys. So Not a bad blaster, not too shabby. Hey, it's better than I have been doing out of Bowman. I've spent a crap ton of Bowman and only pulled two number cards. That was it. That's pretty sad. Yeah, when you spend that kind of money and you only have two number cards to show for it, that's pretty pathetic. Like, that's sad. Like, all right, guys. So Matt Brash, rookie card. Don't have a lot of rookies. This is our first rookie, Matt Brash. Javier Baez, Yoan Moncada. We have a stargazing of Eloy Jimenez. We do have an illumination of Xander Bogaerts. Those are nice looking cards. I do like those illuminations. Those are sharp looking cards. Very cool. I do like those a lot. Too bad the corner is pretty bent. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's a little bent down there. So that's a little bit misfortunate too. Alright guys, last pack of magic. Let's see what we can get out of this last one. That was a fun little rip. Jose Altuve, Albert Pujols, Hunter Green rookie card, Kevin Smith rookie card, and we do have a purple. It is going to be a Ravier San Martin is our purple. And that will do it out of this blaster. It's a nice looking purple there. It's a tier 2. So pretty cool. That will do it out of this little rip. I will basically get right into the Elite Extra. Wow, Panini has terrible quality control. I don't know if you guys can see that. Look at that. Look how bad those cards are bent. That is horrible. Hold on, let me get a good focus. Yeah, look at that bent action going on. That is terrible. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Panini has terrible quality control. I mean, look at that. Wow. Good thing these are only base cards. That's why I don't buy Panini a lot. I try to tend to stay away from them. Their card quality control is absolutely horrid. It is not worth it. So, yeah, that will do it for this rip. There's a nice illumination. Stargazing. A white prism. There is a silver. Another white wave prism. Lumber. Fireworks. Purple. A white wave prism. A rookie class. And we did get an auto of Matt Vierling. So we did get another purple as well. I forgot to include that. Is Ravier San Martin as well. We got some couple rookies, like three. Just three base rookies. I'll leave that auto up there. So let's get into this Elite Extra Edition. Maybe we can pull a killer auto. Let's hope we hit a nice auto out of this. So far we are 1 for 2. We did hit an auto, so that's exactly what I was wanting to do. Out of the sprint, please pull an auto out of Prism, and we did that. Unfortunately, it has a couple scuff marks on it, but what are you going to do? That's Panini for you. Pretty crappy quality. You do get one pack, I believe, out of this blaster. Look at that. One lonely pack. Kind of sad. All by himself. One measly pack. 5 cards. I think that's all you get. So, 2 of them are going to be the auto and the relic. So, let's see, guys. Let's see what we can do. There's Drew Jones and Jackson Holiday on the front. So let's see what we can do. This is my first look at Elite Extra. Let's see if we can pull a nice auto, guys. That's what we're shooting for. I'll tell you what, Bowman has been absolute garbage to me. I've been very upset with Bowman. Spent a lot of money, nothing to show for. Like I said, 2 number cards, and that was it. That's all I got. So that was pretty pretty disappointing. We start off with a number card of Robert Arias, number to 999. Nice looking card there. Robert Arias. Is it 291 out of 999? We did get, there is our auto, I'm assuming. Logan Wagner. Okay, that might be our auto. Could be wrong. Yep, that is our auto, Logan Wagner. Okay. That is a nice looking card, Hidden Gems. I do like his penmanship. It's a nice looking auto right there. Logan Wagner. On the Hidden Gems. Here is our relic. Jalvin Arias. There we go. Jalvin Arias is our relic card. It's not numbered or anything. We did get another number card. It is a Ryan Jennings number to 90. Oh, that's cool. It's like a little die cut card. That's a sharp looking card. Yeah, it's kind of cut out. I thought Panini screwed me over again. They only sent me half of a card and they cut it out or something. But yeah, that's pretty cool. It's a die cut. So that's a pretty nice looking card. Nice looking Ryan Jennings. Number to 90. 30 out of 90. So that's a pretty cool looking card. That's interesting. I like that card right there. That's a sharp looking card. And we got a pink parallel. It is of Enyer Cepeda or Cepeda. Cepeda. That's what I'm thinking. Enyer Cepeda. It's an Elite Extra Edition. He's a Dominican Prospect League. So looks like he's a pitcher maybe. So that's a cool looking pink. I don't know. Is he a pitcher? I'm not too sure. I want to say he is. So it's saying they play for different positions for different teams, but Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Jose Ramirez, and Juan Soto all came through the same pipeline. Now Cepeda hopes to join their ranks, just like his all-star predecessors. He suited up for the Dominican Prospect League with eyes squarely set upon reaching the bigs. That's pretty cool. Came from the same league as, or the same prospect club as Juan Soto and Vladimir Guerrero Jr. So that's pretty cool. Not too bad, guys. I have to admit, that was kind of fun. We did get an auto and a relic, so that was pretty cool. Unlike Bowman, I ripped so much of that crap. It's basically what it is. It's pretty much crap. I don't know what it is. To me, it's pretty much crap because I've opened so much of it and only two number cards, but it's not really worth it to me. I was kind of bummed, like I said. Hasn't been very fun. I've been very disappointed with Bowman. I have two more blasters coming from Dix. I will try those. If I don't hit anything out of those two blasters from Dix, I think I'm going to get an elite box. And then after that, I think I'm going to be done after the elite box. That's pretty cool die cut right there. I do like that a lot. That's sharp. Looks like part of the card is missing. That's pretty cool. Like I said, I'm going to get an elite box and go from there and see how I do. I think after, not an elite box, my fault, I'm going to be getting a retail box. So let me rephrase that. I don't know what I said previously, but I got two more blasters coming from Dix. If I don't hit anything good out of those two, I'm going to get a retail box from Dix. If I don't hit anything good from that, I'm done with Bowman. Pretty much I'll be done after that retail box as well. Like I said, I got two coming from Dix, two retail blasters. If I don't hit anything good, then I will definitely get a a retail box from Dick's as well. Yes, I will get a retail box from Dick's. And that should be it for me as far as Bowman. I'm not going to rip any more Bowman after that retail. Because, like I said, I spent a lot of money and it hasn't been what it's cracked up to be. Actually, I think it's on par with Topps 2023 Series 1. That's how bad I think it is. Some people might argue with me and say, oh, it's better than Topps 2023. But when you open that many blasters and only hit two number of cards, that's pretty bad. I mean, that is a bad rip. That is a bad product. I mean, that just shows you how watered down it is. It's pretty sad. I mean, when you have that kind of odds, especially when they hyped it all up saying blasters have all the hits, and you know, some people might get lucky than others and might hit better cards in their blasters, but I have proof that the blasters are not what they're cracked up to be. And it's not luck, because I have tremendous good luck as far as, you know, rips. I mean, you've seen my videos, how lucky I've been and how many hits I've had, and just all the just all the hits I've had in the past. So I don't think luck has anything to do with it. I just think that product is just so watered down. It's bad. Like, it really is. Like I said, six blasters, two number cards. That's ridiculous. That's pathetic. At that kind of money, I could have bought a hobby box and had guaranteed a hit. So I don't know where all these people saying blasters are very good. I mean, to some people, they probably are. They have had good luck. But me, I have proof that they're pretty much watered down. That product, Bowman overall, is watered down. 2023, they made a lot of that crap. They made a lot of Bowman. And it's watered down. It's just like Topps 2023. Pretty much. It's pretty much on par with it. It's pretty much on par with Topps 2023. So, I mean, if you don't believe me, check out my videos. I mean, that's proof right there. Six blasters, two number cards. That's pathetic. Like, that is pretty doggone pathetic. So yeah, like I said, that's pretty watered down. I mean, if people are getting all these hits left and right, I don't know where they're getting their blasters, but they really have some crazy luck, because I have good luck too. And not to be able to have any good hits or pulls. And like I said, the quality control, that's another story. Those two hits that I got, I had to send them right away because they've had dings and scratches on them. And that's another thing. Bowman's quality control is terrible. It's absolutely terrible. It's on par with Panini, and that's pretty bad. Yeah, it's pretty pathetic. Like I said, the two number cards I did hit, I had to send them away to Topps to get them fixed, because they've either had scratches, they've had blemishes or marks on them, like dents or some kind of issues with them. So enough of me ranting. I appreciate you guys stopping by and checking out this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. It was a fun little rip. I actually did enjoy that Elite Extra edition. That was a lot of fun. I would definitely get another one, just because of the fact you get some number cards, you get an auto, you get a mem. Granted, they're upcoming prospects, you probably don't know a whole lot about them, but Drew Jones is in there, so is Jackson Holiday. So, I mean, at least you're guaranteed to get a hit, and for $25, it's not a bad price. I mean, that's pretty fair. I mean, that's, you're not probably going to make your money back, but like, if you go out and buy Bowman, it's kind of hit or miss. Whereas these, you're guaranteed to get a hit at least. Preferably, personally, I kind of do like this better than Bowman. Just the fact that I haven't hit anything and I spent a crap ton of money, which kind of pissed me off. Like, I thought I was at least going to get a hit in every blaster. I'm not saying an auto, but at least a hit, or somewhat a card that's worth investing in. But I just felt like it was kind of lackluster, big time. So if you haven't already, please smash the subscribe button. I appreciate your guys' support. Hit that thumbs up as well. Lets me know you guys like this video, and I appreciate your guys' continued support. Let's try to grow this channel to 1,000, subscribers. When I hit 1,000, I will do a giveaway for a month for 10 months. If I hit 1,200 subscribers, my goal is to do a giveaway once a month for the whole year. So every month, I will draw a name out randomly. Once you leave a comment, I'll draw, write your name in the comment or post your username in the comment. Once I hit 1,000, 1,200, obviously I got to get there. When I do, that's how I'll do it. I'll pull a name out of the comments that I've got, for that particular video, and whoever's name I pulled will get, it could be a blaster, it could be a value pack, it could be, I haven't got that far yet, but I'm trying to grow it to 1,000, and hopefully we'll hit 1,200 at some point. So, thanks again, guys. Stay tuned for Fun Day Fridays. I know this Saturday I'm going to be doing another Donruss Diamond Kings hobby box, so I'm excited about that. I had a lot of fun on the last hobby box of that, so we will do another one of those. So, looking forward to that this Saturday. So, stay tuned for that. It'll be another hobby box of Donruss Diamond Kings. So, you're guaranteed one auto and one mem out of there. So maybe we can pull, get lucky, and get a downtown out of there as well. So hope you guys have a good rest of your Monday. Until then, I'll see you guys in the next video. Be safe, have fun collecting, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.